Hello, welcome to Liberica Bar, small talks about OpenJDK and Java in informal way. Today we are going to discuss the hottest topic for our followers and for clients, BellSoft clients, the migration from Oracle JDK to OpenJDK. In this theme will help us Alexander Bilakrylov, the CEO of BellSoft. Hello, Alexander, nice to see you
today. Hello, Alice. Hello. Hello, everybody.
So, Alexander, could you tell us, please, if a person wants to have free and secure Java with support, should he use Oracle or OpenJDK?
Yeah, Oracle is still the main contributor of OpenJDK, and of course, using Oracle Java is absolutely safe and the number one choice. However, as we all know, the license for Oracle Java have been changed at the beginning of 2019, and since then, to use Oracle Java for productive environments, the customers organizations have to pay for subscription, for Java subscription. And not all organizations yet decided whether we wanna pay for Oracle or we wanna move to OpenJDK.
Is there any possibilities not to pay for Oracle Java if they want to use it?
Yeah, absolutely. It's possible to use the versions of Oracle JDK before Oracle JDK 8 update 2.0.2, which was the last publicly available update of JDK 8. And our experience shows that many organizations, like I would say like 20% of organizations, are still on this last public update of JDK, Oracle JDK. We haven't moved to licensed to supported Oracle Java, nor we moved to OpenJDK. So we're still in kind of situation that we are making decision. We haven't yet decided whether we, where are we moved.
Mm-hmm. And I hear that there could be some problems there because it's very old software. It should be unsecure as far as I know.
No problem, just security risks.
I can say that it's not a problem.
That's right. Of course, yeah, since the last public updates of Oracle Java, many, like more than 50 security issues was fixed. That means that the systems which use outdated Java runtime are vulnerable. So potentially we could be compromised. And those risks lays directly to the IT teams which supports those applications. So they are considering, they are taking those risks. Maybe they not quite sure. And as many people say, like it haven't happened yet, so we do have some time to make a decision.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think a lot of people just don't know about their big vulnerability lists, and it's interesting information. If you will subscribe on your BellSoft newsletter, you will find there the vulnerability lists. I think it could be helpful for your organization, and BellSoft will tell you what is the problems with these vulnerabilities and how they can be harmful for your company. And Alexander, but if we are talking about migration and OpenJDK, what is their biggest fear for your clients? What are they afraid for?
Yeah, some developers, some IT professionals, they still think that OpenJDK is something for hobbyists, so it's not for production use. I would say this time passed a long ago, and today we do have many OpenJDK distributions based on the source code of OpenJDK. And Oracle JDK is not an exclusion of that. Oracle JDK is based on OpenJDK 2. So, we actually created an article which addresses this like fears. And I would say that the most common fear is that OpenJDK is not secured.
Like any open source.
It's not supported by professional teams. It's like somebody contributes there. And another common fear is that OpenJDK does not have the same features as Oracle JDK. And this is a pretty important topic. And here I could see that Oracle was so pleasant to contribute everything, every commercial features of JDK to OpenJDK and made it available for the community, OpenJDK community, and continue to support those features in OpenJDK. For example, Java Flight Recorder, called now JDK Flight Recorder, it was contributed by, it used to be a commercial feature of JDK 8, and it's still a commercial feature of JDK 8 at Oracle Java. However, Oracle contributed this feature to the OpenJDK upstream. And by OpenJDK contributors, this functionality was backported to OpenJDK 8. And now OpenJDK 8 supported by OpenJDK distributions, and Liberica JDK supports Java Flight Recorder 2 in 8 version.
Yeah, that's cool.
In addition, to use Java Flight Recorder effectively, the companies and users need to have JDK mission control. Mission control is an open source project also. And Liberica JDK, Liberica Mission Control, based on that code base and provides by BellSoft, also at BellSoft website. So the users which used to use Oracle Mission Control together with Java Flight Recorder can do it by using open source solutions now.
Mm. Is there any helpful tools that the customer could find in OpenJDK, in Liberica JDK, but can't find it in Oracle JDK, some special and for expert tools and so on?
If we're talking about tools, I could see that OpenJDK currently supports more platforms. And for instance, Liberica JDK supported the biggest number of platform in JDK 11. And for example, a pretty important and pretty popular piece of software is OpenJDK on Alpine Linux. It's out of Oracle support, however, it's supported by BellSoft. And BellSoft created a JDK enhancement proposal to make this functionality at the upstream of OpenJDK, and it's targeted for JDK 16 now. So JDK 16 support for Alpine Linux, tiny containers, tiny Docker containers by OpenJDK will become an OpenJDK upstream.
Yeah, it's really cool. And is there any other pluses of working with Liberica JDK but not Oracle JDK?
Yeah, for desktop users, Liberica JDK BellSoft offers Liberica Administration Center. Firstly, it allows to scan the organization infrastructure and find all Java versions which used on desktops and organize that information and show it, visualize it, to allow IT professionals to understand what vendors and what Java versions is used within their infrastructure. In addition, it provides also information about applications which use Java on desktops. And you can see that it's pretty simple to find on the desktop such information. Yes, however, if you have a big organization with thousands of desktops, it's really time-consuming task, and we simplify and accelerate that that task dramatically. So, in addition, Liberica Administration Center allows to update Liberica JDK on the pace that organization needs.
And what about, for example, management? Is there any motivations for your clients why they are choosing BellSoft support but not Oracle support?
Yeah, the main motivation is cost, price. So Liberica JDK is OpenJDK binary. However, the support cost is not so pricey as Oracle support. On the other hand, Liberica JDK is supported by former Oracle Java engineers, which work in BellSoft. So, yeah, we are one of the leading OpenJDK contributors as a company. And our approach to providing support to our customers is to contribute every patch we do to OpenJDK upstream to eliminate any vendor lock-in. So we do provide support the true open source way.
And all your customers and customers of any other OpenJDK vendor just can, they will have these fixes too.
Yeah, absolutely. The fixes what we do are available at any distributions at Oracle, JDK, Red Hat, JDK, any distribution.
It's convenient, yeah. And what about some customer success stories? Could you please about some of your clients? Why? What was the main reasons of their migration?
Yeah, the main reason, of course, it's price, right? However, some companies as JetBrains. JetBrains has their own runtime called JetBrains Runtime.
Is it based on Liberica?
It's OpenJDK fork, which supported by BellSoft. So BellSoft provides support to JetBrains to support their JetBrains runtime. And one day JetBrains decided not to support it themselves and find us as a professional team which can provide support more effectively.
Is there any other customer that using Liberica JDK because they can't use Oracle as
I wouldn't say they can't, but for example, Pivotal and currently VMware, they decided to use Liberica JDK and they decided to provide BellSoft support to their customers. As we found, Liberica is then the most effective for their needs.
We can find it in VMware Cloud.
Yeah, it's available in VMware Tanzu Cloud, and all VMware Tanzu Cloud users, customers, they receive Liberica JDK with BellSoft support from VMware.
Well, as far as I understand, Liberica is just a cloud-oriented runtime.
Absolutely.
Because of Docker that he was talking about.
Absolutely, yeah, absolutely. And the supporting microservice architectures and cloud is our main focus. And we are trying to make Java as effective as possible for cloud environments and microservice architectures.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think everything become more clear about migration and Oracle, from Oracle to OpenJDK and to Liberica JDK, where our followers can find some more information about it to just to know the details.
Yeah, we created an article about seven the most common fears that Java users has about moving from Oracle JDK to OpenJDK. And the same article also disclosed the seven benefits what Liberica JDK can bring to its users as OpenJDK binary distributions. And the big part of the article actually is comparison of the features of which exists in Oracle JDK and in OpenJDK feature by feature. So it's like for readers, it would become clear what we would get by moving to OpenJDK and what would we loose.
Yeah, it's awesome. It's quite a convenient table where we can find it and just to make a compare. So that's cool. For others that would like to know more about migration and about interesting tools of Liberica JDK, you can subscribe on our newsletter on BellSoft blog and other articles, or just subscribe on our YouTube channel and Twitter. See you in other episode of Liberica Bar, and thank you, Alexander, for details information about migration.
Thank you for the invitation. Thank you for being with us.
Well, bye.
Bye-bye.